A year before the PlayStation 4's launch, us PC gamers got its graphics card, the HD 7870. But how does this play games in 2024, and how does it stack up against the PlayStation 4? See, I did a bit of a rhyme there. Anyways, I think it's time to find out how it gets on. While a lot of PC gamers say the 7850 is the PC equivalent of the PS4's GPU, the console has more compute units and TMUs, while they both have the same ROP count. However, I believe the unlocked power budget of the 7850 and the fact that my model is a slightly beefed Sapphire card, that does close up the performance gap ever so slightly, as they both have around 1.89 teraflops of compute performance. So on paper, I guess you can say they're pretty close. However, how does this first gen GCN graphics card get on in 2024? Well, it's time to find out. I've tested it at 1080p, which is the resolution most PS4 games are going to be running at. All testing has been done in my Ryzen 5 7600 testing PC, which has 32GB of 6200MHz CL32 DDR5 memory, a 2TB Western Digital Gen 4 NVMe SSD, and an MSI X670E Tomahawk. I've used the official AMD legacy driver, which is 22.6.1C. I've actually remembered a driver name for once, and the stock settings have been used for this Sapphire graphics card. So, let's see how it gets on. So I decided to try something with some modern relevance in Fortnite, and the HD 7850 performed pretty decently here, getting triple figures for the average frame rate, and then the 1% low was looking somewhat okay at 62 FPS. But in all fairness, this really old GPU is performing very well in Fortnite, and it's performing better than the PlayStation 4 as well, albeit it is on the performance API, so yeah. But regardless, Fortnite is performing quite well. The same can't be said for Spider-Man Remastered on the lowest preset, because 22 FPS on average with a very meager 1% low of 15 FPS means, yeah, the game isn't going to be very playable at all. In all fairness, it is a big ask for this graphics card. Also, Cyberpunk 2077 is too much of an ask, because the frame rate is, it's not looking great on my custom lower than low preset, because 21 FPS on average with 12 for that 1% low isn't, it's not great, let's be honest. God of War is only slightly more playable on the lowest preset with just 26 FPS on average, so it didn't even reach the 30 that the PS4 can do, so that is a bit of a shame, to be honest. But in all fairness, you've got to weigh up the fact that this GPU was like a budget one from 12 years ago, so to be honest, it is expected. Good thing though, because Skyrim Special Edition is, well, it's playable with 47 FPS on average with a 1% low of 40. Yes, it's not getting that magical 60 FPS number that you're going to be after, but it's certainly a lot more playable than the previous three games, and it's more playable than what the PS4 would have been running at anyway, so that is a bit of a win in my opinion. Defecting to the Xbox games instead of using PlayStation titles, Halo Master Chief Collection with Halo Reach runs perfectly fine on this GPU. The original preset nets 95 FPS on average, so we were just shy of that 100 FPS mark, but the 1% low is also looking pretty good at 70 FPS as well, so I don't think you're going to be having any problems in this title. Counter-Strike 2 is notably a CPU demanding game, but you do need a GPU to at least drive some frames, and the 7850 can do that with 100 dead for that average frame rate and 73 FPS for the 1% low, which isn't too bad for CSGO, or CS2 as it is now. They're basically the same game, it's just CS2 is harder to run. Anyways, I think you're going to be having a decent competitive gaming experience here. Nothing to write home about though, but the fact that the 7850 can do this is pretty astonishing in my opinion. Well, I've certainly tested faster cards on my time benchmarking here on the channel, but credit where credit's due, the 7850 did at least start every single game I wanted to test today. But that's where its victories end, in games like Cyberpunk, God of War, and Spider-Man, because the performance in these titles is well, it's not playable. It's below 30 FPS, and that's not playable in my opinion. However though, you could probably improve this frame rate by enabling FSR, as FSR is somehow supported on this GPU, but this will degrade visual quality even further, especially as it's not really that good at 1080p, and you're going to be running on low in basically every single one of these games anyway. But to be honest with you, it's not all doom and gloom, because competitive games like Rainbow Six Siege, Fortnite and Counter-Strike 2 all run pretty decently on this card, all things considered. Particularly Fortnite and Counter-Strike, they were quite good today. And if you want to play some older games, Skyrim, Halo Master Chief Collection, not too bad on this graphics card, even though in Skyrim you're not going to be getting 60 FPS, but the PlayStation's locked to 30 anyway, so there is a bit of a win there for this GPU. And if I'm being honest with you lot here, I think it's much more fun to test an older graphics card like this than testing something a lot more powerful like a 4070 Super or something, because you're kind of restrained with this. Yes, it's good to see the latest and greatest games running at like 90-ish FPS plus, but it's more of a challenge to find out what can run on older hardware like this, and yeah, this is why I'll always test GPUs like this. You might be wondering why the HD 7870 isn't as fast or faster than the PS4, and there's one word for that: optimization. Console developers only have to develop for a handful of hardware configurations. With the PS4, it was probably like two, with the base PS4 and the Pro, but with PC, there are thousands of hardware configurations. Obviously, this is going to be much harder to optimize for compared to a console, of course. And this is what at least partially explains the spaghetti code slot ports we've been getting on PC recently, as a lot of newly released titles on PC aren't optimized very well. So can the PS4's desktop GPU play games in 2024? Yeah, but nothing relatively that modern. But if you want to play some of these games, I highly recommend checking out this GPU up here. With that being said, I'll catch you in the next one.